Hey guys, VD Soundtrack Guy here. As I promised, I would test out the M-Audio Keystation Pro here. I've got my Klipsch speakers on each side, which I can actually fit, since there's so much space on here, I can fit my module synth or full-size speakers on here like Yamaha Tyro style. So what we're going to do here is I'm going to test this out. I have my Zoom H1 connected to the audio to the synthesizer, the synthesizer to the Zoom H1, then the Zoom H1 to the speakers, so I can hear myself. And we're just gonna test it out. But here we go, Zoom H1 audio, and we're gonna start right now. We're just gonna test out a little bit of something here. Sort of messed up there a little bit. Flat minor. Let's go to piano. One of my favorites here, piano and strings. But before I do that, I'm gonna take the reverb off. I don't like reverb, so we're gonna take it off. Okay, we'll do a little B flat groove. All right, sorry about that. Capture ran out of time, so I'm going to hurry this up. I'll play a little bit on the piano on this thing, and then I'll show you some of the buttons and stuff like that. But there'll be another video of me using these sliders over here, these non-sliders for draw bars on the Native Instruments B4. So let's go ahead and do this now. All right, we'll start out with this. Now let's see here. There's one I'd like to really try out on this thing. One patch in the orchestra section, an orchestra and brass, and it's called. I think it's called Film Layers. Let's go ahead and see. Yep, it's called. Actually, it's called Full Orchestra. I like this patch here. Alright, let me sync. Well, it should already be synchronized, so we should be good. Out the pitch bend wheel and a little bit of modulation, it makes the string sound very tremolo-y, so that's nice. I don't think there's really anything else I'll show out besides that. Very nice. I like this keyboard. I can't use the sliders though on this thing because it has some weird freaky deaky stuff to this synthesizer over here, this module. Just some weird freaky stuff. One slider enables portamento, and it just gets freaky after that. So I don't touch those. I don't touch these knobs either. I'll turn off the keyboard, then turn all the knobs down, and then, you know, leave it at that. But as for the buttons and everything else, I don't know. But let me see. That's transpose. You push the, click the two buttons in, and you can transpose it. So let's see how that sounds real quick. Mm-hmm. sounds nice. You can transpose that. That's real cool. So that's real nice. We'll put it back at 1. So you can switch between the transpose and octaves. And octaves by pushing down both buttons. So that's really cool. That is really, really cool. One more feature I want to show off real quick is layering. And let's say you have a sound module and you can't layer on board the sound module at all. Take MIDI channel 1 and take this and take piano for instance. Take MIDI channel 2 and put it on some sort of strings. Push two together and you'll play MIDI channel 1 and MIDI channel 2. You press zone 1 together and zone 2 together and you get piano on strings. Those strings are... sounds a little bit better. That sounds nice. I mean, that sounds all right. That's just about it for this video. This is the M-Audio Pro 88. You will see more of this again when I find the time to put this in my living room where my computer is currently and record some B4, some organ.